and or Jill. We've had a lot of people come here regularly over the years. It started in the 50s and all of that, but you're the longest member of our club. Thank you. Take your cake before... Peaches, you're in charge. You take that thing out of here. All right, keep dancing. Here are the Dregs. Joanne was with us all through the 1970s. Joanne, who is your dancing partner on the show?
That was Hal Long.
Who is here with us now? Hal, what are you up to these days?
I'm working at a law firm and I'm trying to pursue a singing career.
What do you do now?
I work as an executive secretary at Universal Studios.
How many years were you on Benson? You hold the record. I mean, you were there forever.
10 and a half years.
Now, let me get back to something. We're talking about girls' names and songs, Joanne and so forth. Names and songs, we've had hundreds of them on the show, but tonight we're going to concentrate on some real name songs. Let's start with some real movie stars. That's Ben, and he also starred in Willard.
Oh, Al, I am but a fool.
Neil Sedaka wrote this for his real friend, Carole King.
Oh, you treat me cruel.
Now, Bo Diddley did this song and took the name for himself. Bilbo. Now, Bilbo isn't exactly a real person. He's a fictional hobbit character. Now, they're real people and real potatoes, and as you can see, the French fries at Dolores's are called Susie Q's. Those are two songs called Lucille, and thousands of gals are called Lucille, but how many guitars are called Lucille? How many years you had this gal, or is this not the original?
This is not the original. This is Lucille the 15th. I've had others, but people borrow them without my permission.
Finally, is Mandy real? Will only Barry Manilow know.
Next, we review some great performers, including Jackie Wilson, Madonna, Michael Jackson, and on stage, the godfather of soul, James Brown.
Have you ever seen anybody that you particularly admired on the stage as one of the movers of all time?
Actually, one of the guys who started it all off was James Brown.
It's interesting you mention James, because James and Jackie Wilson and so forth. I got two phone calls within a month of one another this year. First of all, from Michael Jackson, said, could you send me this tape? I want to take a look at it. And about 2 weeks later, Prince said, I want to see how these people move. And lo and behold, what they're talking about was people like that, because somewhere along the line, the singers just used to stand there, and then all of a sudden, the beat got people moving. A band started getting in the mood by moving their instruments. Then rock bands started moving their feet. Singing groups started to choreograph their performances.
Oh,
open duo. And finally, some great solo movers, male and female.
Sort of a fatherly feeling about this amazing young fellow who sort of grew up on American Bandstand. Michael had his Thriller album. He won 8 Grammys, 7 American Music Awards, 4 Black Gold Awards. Not to mention a Guinness Book record as the biggest selling album in history. All right, who can follow them?